Welcome back to Director's Choice. Loki is one of the most beloved characters in the Avengers universe. He is as beloved as any of the Avengers, maybe even more. So it was no doubt a hurtful blow to his fans when he died for what appeared to be the last time in Avengers Infinity War. But in a pleasurable twist of events, it was announced that Loki will be getting his own show on Disney Plus. Fans can now breathe a sigh of relief, because they will get to see their beloved character on screen once more. So what is the TV show about? And didn't Loki die already? Well, there are some things you will need to know about the upcoming Disney Plus show. And in this video, you will find out what those things are. Keep watching to find out everything that you need to know about Loki. Don't worry, this video doesn't contain any spoilers, so you can watch it with both eyes open. Also, make sure to watch to the end so you can find out when Loki is going to make its debut. What's more, we expect that the Loki series will give us more insight into the titular character and his struggles. While nobody is likely to mistake Loki for a hero, it's hard not to feel a measure of sympathy for him sometimes. It was hard not to feel sorry for him after the discovery of his Frost Giant origins in the first Thor movie, which was released in 2010. This drove Loki to become even angrier. This plot has not been explored by the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Rumors flying around claim that the Loki series will take advantage of this untapped mind. The rumors started when the series showrunner Michael Waldron talked about how the titular character's struggle with identity was what drew him to the project in the first place. Waldron said that the series will finally explore Loki's struggle with identity, adding that, over the first 10 years of movies, he's out of control at pivotal parts of his life. He was adopted and everything, and that manifests itself through anger and spite towards his family. As you would expect, he wasn't very forthcoming about other information, as Marvel likes to keep their cards very close to their chest. Nevertheless, this is one plot that we can't wait to see fully explored in the upcoming series. We're excited to see how it's all going to play out. No doubt, fans of the Marvel Cinematic Universe who watched Loki die for the umpteenth time in Avengers Infinity War may be wondering how exactly it is that he gets to star in his own show when he was already killed. While you may think that the upcoming series will be a prequel to the Avengers movies, you would be wrong. According to a press release and the official synopsis that was released by Disney, the series will follow Thor's unruly brother as he pops up throughout human history as an unlikely influencer on historical events. Quite a number of teasers and trailers have been released that give us an inkling about what to expect in the show, and we are beyond excited for the full series to drop. According to the trailers and teasers, Loki gets arrested by the Time Variance Authority, which fans know is the organization that is charged with protecting the timeline in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. In one of the released trailers, a TVA agent named Mobius reveals that Loki broke reality when he vanished during the events of Endgame, and that the TVA wants Loki to fix his mistake and help the organization restore reality. Knowing Loki as well as we do, we can expect that he will escape from the TVA and continue to wreak havoc. While we don't know for sure what will happen in the series, a scene on a trailer shows Loki saying that Heimdall and Thor better be ready. Fans know Rat Heimdall died in Avengers Infinity War, so is this a way of saying that he is also coming back from the dead? There is so much that we are expecting from this series, and we sure can't wait to have Loki back on our screens. It has been confirmed that rather than the series being a prequel, as many fans thought, it does, in fact, take place after the events of Avengers Endgame. This was implied by a clip of Hiddleston's cameo in Loki's first trailer. Disney's official synopsis says that, in Marvel Studios' Loki, the mercurial villain Loki resumes his role as the god of mischief in a new series that takes place after the events of Avengers Endgame. We can't wait to see how the new series will play out. Like a lot of things about the series, the exact plot of Loki is still being kept heavily under wraps, so there isn't a lot that we know about it. Marvel likes to keep their secrets closely guarded, but once in a while, leaks happen. One of such leaks tells us a connection in Loki that we are eagerly looking forward to. While this hasn't been expressly confirmed by Marvel, the rumors are that the Loki series will set setup events of Thor: Love and Thunder by seeing Loki somehow find a way to return to the main MCU timeline, with an alternate version of Mjolnir with him. The rumors claim that this will be used to facilitate Jane Foster's transformation into Mighty Thor. What information has been confirmed came from the lips of Disney boss Bob Iger, who confirmed in a press interview that the series will somehow connect to Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, another Marvel Phase 4 release which will include Elizabeth Olsen in the role of Scarlet Witch. Olsen also has her own Disney Plus series titled WandaVision. Of course, Bob Iger did not reveal exactly how the events of Loki will connect to Doctor Strange and Thor, but we guess the suspense will make the watch even better. A lot of popular names in the acting community have already been confirmed to be starring in the upcoming series. Of course, Tom Hiddleston, who has played Loki in the Marvel Cinematic Universe for more than 10 years, will star in the series as the titular character. Unfortunately, he is the only MCU veteran who has been confirmed to be appearing in the series. We can expect Chris Hemsworth to drop in once in a while for a brief appearance or a cameo, seeing as his character Thor is Loki's brother. Zoolander and Wedding Crashers Owen Wilson has also been confirmed to be appearing in the series, but the role he plays is still being kept under wraps. Some leaks claim that he will be playing the role of Mobius, the TVA agent who works with Loki to try to fix the timeline that Loki ruined. This marks Wilson's first role in a superhero feature. Black Mirror actress Gugu Mbatha-Raw has also been confirmed to be appearing in the upcoming series. As is usual with Marvel, the character she plays in the series is still under wraps. Rumors, however, have it that she will be playing Rayona Lexus Renslayer. Other members of the cast include the British actress Sofia Di Martino, who, according to the rumors, will be playing the female version of Loki. Lovecraft Country actress Wunmi Mosaku has also been confirmed to have been cast in the series as Hunter B-15. In March 2020, Richard E. Grant was cast in the series, with his exact role still being kept under wraps. Blindspot actress Jamie Alexander has also been said to be likely to reprise her role as Sif from previous Thor movies. In October 2020, it was confirmed that Sasha Lane will also be appearing in the series, in a yet-to-be-disclosed role. While we may not know the characters that these famous actors are playing yet, we know for sure that the series is going to make for a very interesting watch indeed. In late 2019, Loki actor Tom Hiddleston had an interview with MTV News to promote his stage play Betrayal. But like MTV commonly does, the outlet managed to get him to talk a little bit about the Loki series. Hiddleston revealed that the series would span 6 hours. While this could easily be a reference to the series' confirmed duration of 6-hour-long episodes, we can't help but wonder if there's more to the story than that. A trailer released soon after this shows Loki being taken to the Time Variance Authority, where Mobius M. Mobius explains that time passes differently. And this makes us wonder if this is a reference to the duration of the movie. While it is possible that the entire series only takes place in 6 hours, the possibilities with Marvel are wide, and we wouldn't be surprised if they pull a fast one on us. We don't exactly trust the MCU in cases like this. Speaking about our distrust of the MCU in certain situations, Loki was initially announced to be a limited series like WandaVision, but we now know that Marvel was not entirely honest in their initial portrayal of Loki as a miniseries. This is because Loki has already been renewed for a second season. It isn't common for a series to get renewed for a second season when the first season hasn't even debuted yet, but this is a testament to the fact that both Marvel and Disney Plus believe that the show is going to be a mega hit. Some sources claim that the second season will start production in January 2022. It's unclear whether this was a later development or it was originally planned to have at least 2 seasons. As we said, the MCU can't exactly be trusted in situations like this. Nothing is known about the plotline for the second season, but we can expect that Tom Hiddleston and the other major characters in season 1 will be returning for the second season, and that some new characters may be introduced too. Now that you know so much about Loki and what to expect, we bet you want to know when you'll finally be able to watch it. Loki was announced in November 2018, and filming began a little over a year later in January 2020 in Atlanta, Georgia. But filming was briefly suspended in March 2020 due to the spread of the COVID-19 pandemic and the ensuing COVID protocols that prevented large gatherings. Filming and production resumed in September 2020 and rounded up in December 2020. So when exactly will the series make its debut? The series is scheduled to make its premiere on June 11th, 2021, and it will have 6 episodes that will be anywhere from 50 minutes to an hour long watch. Loki will be part of Phase 4 of the MCU. MCU Phase 4 includes the movies WandaVision, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, Ms. Marvel, Hawkeye, and other MCU series. We can't wait until we'll finally be able to watch Loki. It has been quite a long wait. Loki is one of the most anticipated series of the year, as fans have been waiting for a long time to finally watch one of their favorite characters return to the screen. We are just as excited as you for the June premiere of the series. How excited are you about the series? What do you think about Loki as a character? Let us know what you think in the comments. Take a look at this recent clip by Director's Choice, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications.